Good evening. If I could ask everyone to please return to their cars so we can begin our ceremony. Welcome to the 2020 Portland High School commencement exercises. I am Kate Lawson, the very proud principal of Portland High School, and I am grateful for the opportunity to bring us all together to celebrate the accomplishments of an outstanding group of young men and women. I cannot begin tonight, though, without thanking an outstanding group of parents who spent most of today decorating this beautiful stage for our ceremony. Thank you, Project Graduation. I ask you tonight not to focus on the class of 2020's obstacles. We all know there have been many, but to enjoy their youth, their enthusiasm, and their desire to make their mark on the world, and most specifically our community of Portland. I have said to them before that other than the five children I have at home, they are the most important young people in the world to me. I told them at freshman orientation that to be successful, they would need to do the following: come to school, do their homework, be nice to one another, and get involved. I am happy to say they have answered the call. And to the parents, thank you from the bottom of my heart for sharing your children with me and our faculty. Thank you for trusting us with your most treasured gifts. I hope we have lived up to your expectations, and I can assure you that your children have exceeded ours. We are blessed, we are lucky, and we are here tonight to celebrate. Before I turn the program over to our first speaker, I have a few directions for the evening. We have four staff members assisting us with staging our graduates: Mrs. Ionello, Ms. Terry, Mrs. Laverty, and Ms. Choquette. They will socially distance the graduates across the walkway to my left, your right, as they approach the podium. And this is where the graduates will prepare to cross the stage. The teachers will come and get the graduates from their car and line them up. Each family is invited to move to the sitting area in front of the podium when their graduate is either delivering their speech or having their name called. I ask that when your child is second in line or on deck, that you move to the left of the sitting area in this front corner to be able to take your seats when the graduate is called. Graduates, you may remove your masks when lining up, when on stage, and while being photographed. Dr. O'Reilly has honored us tonight by announcing the names of our graduates. He will not call any names until each family is comfortably seated. After the students' names are announced, they will accept their diploma from Mrs. Sharon Peters, our chairwoman of the Board of Education. They will be photographed on stage, receive a flower, and proceed. At that time, the graduates should turn their tassel from right to left and proceed down the stairs to my right, receive their yearbook, and return to their cars. We are lucky to have such a beautiful night. It was certainly worth the wait. Please enjoy the evening and our program. It is now my pleasure to introduce Grant Collins, Senior Class President, to deliver our welcoming address.
Good evening, Dr. O'Reilly, members of the Board of Education, members of the Board of Selectmen, Ms. Lawson, faculty, staff, family, friends, and of course, the class of 2020. As class president, I would like to warmly welcome and thank everybody who was with us on this very special occasion, and everyone watching along at home. I would also like to thank our class advisors, Ms. Terry, Ms. Choquette, and Mrs. Lawrence, for their unwavering commitment to the class of 2020 over the course of our time at Portland High School. I stand before you at the dawn of a decade when every one of us will be called upon to make consequential decisions. These decisions, how to keep ourselves and the community safe, who to vote for, and what freedoms are worth fighting for, must be made with compassion and honesty. How do we make sense of our experiences? From Sandy Hook in the fifth grade, to Parkland, to a global pandemic in which we've lost over 4,000 Connecticut citizens, and most recently, to the exposure of a gash that has been bleeding for centuries. We cannot ignore the division of race and culture and the fear of a once-in-a-century global health crisis any longer. We have to be truthful about these realities and our own emotions. We must believe we can overcome these times, and we must act with compassion. I know we can do it, because we have done it before. I'm not talking about awards, accolades, or championships. I'm talking about overcoming real adversity to graduate. I know we have all been bullied, called racial or homophobic slurs, lost a grandparent, lacked focus, faced anxiety, battled a health condition. Or we've suffered through a tumultuous and volatile home life, had a family member deployed, or seen addiction grip our families. Maybe we've worn the quote, wrong thing, failed the test, lost the game, didn't fit in, yet we all made it to this day. And we will continue to make it. Now, we must think about what our classmates have endured and show them compassion. We must extend that compassion to our community. Wear a mask, embrace diversity. After all, diversity of thought will feed our brains, and diversity of people will feed our souls. We must thank the people who made a difference in our lives, the ones who encouraged us to keep grinding and express how much they mean to us. For me, high school was extremely challenging. And if it weren't for people like Coach K, Ms. Choquette, and Coach Borg, I would have never made it to this day. Who mattered to you? Take responsibility to vote in the most critical election in contemporary history. We must not let fear, entrenched positions, or social media be our guide. It's a matter of life, death, and freedom. Will the leaders we elect act with compassion and honesty? We must recognize the pain, anguish, and injustice our country was built upon and educate ourselves to the best of our abilities. This decade must be different. Congratulations, class of 2020. Stand up, speak out, and lead with compassion and honesty. Thank you. Now please join me in listening to our a cappella singers as they share the PHS alma mater.
As we stand here together on our old beloved hill, our footprints last forever on the past we have fulfilled. And so will all the memories we shared within these walls. We'll think of all the good times when last we leave these halls. When to Portland high we say our last farewell, and turn our sights to what may lie ahead. The Highlander will always and forever be the emblem of the old black and red.
At this time, I would like to introduce my friend, Olivia Runty, the salutatorian, of the class of 2020.
Good evening, Dr. O'Reilly, members of the Board of Education, members of the Board of Selectmen, Ms. Lawson, faculty, staff, family, friends, and the class of 2020. Before I begin, I would like to take a second to thank the faculty and staff here at Portland High School for their never-ending support and encouragement. I will miss you all so much. To my mom, dad, and brother, I would not be standing here without you. Thank you. To the class of 2020, I am honored to be here tonight as your salutatorian. Graduation marks the end of one of the most important journeys in our lives. After 4 long years at Portland High School, the time has finally come for us to embark on the next chapter. And with the absolute craziness that was the second half of senior year, it brings me great joy to say that we have finally made it. On August 31st, 2016, we entered PHS for the first time as small freshmen who had absolutely no idea what was going on. It has been exactly 1,381 days since that moment. And while I can't speak for everyone, I can say that I still have absolutely no idea what's going on. It's hard for me to swallow the fact that I am now an adult who can vote for the first time ever in November, who can buy a lottery ticket, and who, in a few short months, will be leaving home for college. And it's not just me. Over these past 4 years, I have watched every person in this class grow into a young adult. I have watched from the sidelines, secretly cheering you all on, as people started to reach huge milestones, like getting their license, devising their plans for the future, and finding their voice. It was incredible to witness everyone mature into who we are meant to be. Along the way, we have made a ton of great memories that I will be sure to cherish forever, like the Virginia Beach band and chorus trip, our trip to New York City in November, and winning tug of war against the seniors our freshman year. There are plenty of funny memories too, like when the fire alarm went off multiple times last year in one day, and at the winter pep rally this year, when multiple classes were screaming at each other and at me for spirit points. Every experience that we have had at Portland and every memory we have made, both good and bad, have contributed to our growth. For that, I am extremely grateful. Unfortunately, due to the coronavirus, our time was cut short and we were unable to make more memories and properly finish our senior year. Thursday, March 11th, was the last time that we walked the halls of Portland High School, and we didn't even realize it at the time. Sometimes I forget that school only closed in March because it honestly feels like a lifetime ago. There are so many things that I was looking forward to. The Disney trip, being able to say goodbye to my teachers, and hugging my friends on graduation night. 2020 has certainly not been the year that we were expecting. I vividly remember my excitement leading up to New Year's Eve for the start of a new decade. I wish I could go back in time to tell myself to buckle up for the bumpy ride. We were robbed of significant high school experiences, and it is perfectly fine to feel sad, disappointed, angry even at the events that transpired this year. This is time that we will never get back. However, we as a generation are not strangers to turmoil. We were born shortly after the September 11th attacks and have since dealt with the danger of school shootings, the imminent threat of climate change, lack of equality, an unbelievably divided country, and now a global pandemic. This is not even the entire list. We are 17 and 18 years old, and we as a generation have experienced and are currently still experiencing an absurd number of threats. For years, we have seen what has been going on in the country and around the world, and we have had no choice but to sit back and watch. This is about to change. This class consists of future doctors and nurses who have been inspired by the global pandemic and want to be on the front lines like myself. Future lawyers and politicians who see the unfair justice system and laws and are determined to make changes. Future teachers and professors who want to educate future generations on social issues and teach them how to be compassionate and accept others. Rather than let these obstacles drag us down, they have inspired us. They have shaped us as people and influenced how we are choosing to spend the rest of our lives. We are the generation that will elicit positive change, and I have never felt so motivated to get to work than I do right now. For those of you who are still struggling to come to terms with how our senior year ended, or that our new normal consists of masks and social distancing, remember, we have dealt with worse. We are still dealing with worse. But we are a generation that is defined by resilience. We haven't been discouraged by the world yet, and we are not allowing it to happen now. I would like to close tonight with a quote by former President Barack Obama. "I've seen a generation eager, impatient even, to step into the rushing waters of history and change its course. As we begin this new chapter of our lives, I encourage you all to step into those rushing waters. Take the memories that we were able to make from the past 3 years and the wisdom that you have gained throughout high school and let it guide you. Let the bad things that we have seen and experienced fuel you to leave this world a little bit better than we found it. Learn as much as you can and give back as much as you can. I want all of us to do the great things that I know we are capable of. Even though I won't be able to see you every day, know that I will still be on the sidelines, cheering you on always. I can't wait to see what we are able to accomplish as Portland High School's class of 2020. At this time, I would like to welcome Autumn Tewksbury, valedictorian of the class of 2020, to deliver the valedictory address.
Good evening, Dr. O'Reilly, members of the Board of Education, members of the Board of Selectmen, Ms. Lawson, faculty, staff, family, friends, and the class of 2020. We started this school year like every other senior class. We were excited to be the oldest in the school. And we look forward to our prom, our senior cruise, ditch day, the senior prank, a normal graduation, and spending the last 3 months of high school together. Now we've been reunited after 3 months of quarantine for a graduation that only allows one car per student. This year alone, Kobe Bryant died. Australia burned for 79 days straight. A possible World War III was trending on Twitter. President Donald Trump was on trial for impeachment and later acquitted. A pandemic has killed tens of thousands of people and counting. Murder hornets have recently emerged. Protests across the nation are taking place in demanding justice and equality for African Americans, and it's only June. As some have said, we're only at the mid-season finale of 2020, and I've learned to stop asking if it can get any worse because the answer thus far has always been yes. This pandemic reminded us that life isn't fair, and as a result, we learned to live in the moment, because we know now that our future plans are never a guarantee. Although 2020 was not at all what we expected, we still managed to graduate, and that's something that we should all be very proud of. Hopefully in a few months, many of us will be starting a new chapter of our lives somewhere other than Portland. It'll be unlike these past 12 years have been, as we won't have the same familiarity or the support system that we had growing up. That scares me. There's so much new that we're going to have to learn. And personally, I don't even know how to pay taxes. In the words of Michael Scott, I knew exactly what to do, but in a much more real sense, I had no idea what to do. Despite our fears, I truly do believe that we will be a successful class. Over these past 4 years, I've gotten to know all of you. And when I think of one phrase to describe our class, my immediate thought is personality type B, meaning the majority of us tend to be very relaxed in our approach to schoolwork, often procrastinating until the last minute. Almost every single person in this class is a type B personality, and honestly, I'm jealous because I'm one of the few type A people. But even I had my moments of cramming for a test 5 minutes before class started, especially when it came to Spanish. We may not fit the ideal model of a student, but I've seen the ways that we make each other smile. We are by far the funniest and most relatable class of them all. And while that might not sound very appealing to the job market, it is what matters in the long run. One's personality is so much more important than one's intelligence. It's the reason why we know the name Martin Luther King Jr. and not William James Sidis, who, by the way, is known to be the smartest person in history. Personalities like ours change the world, and they make history. We don't just sit behind our desks and mechanically do work. We talk to one another, we make jokes, and we have fun. When I look back at Portland High School, I don't remember the work at all. I remember Gianni climbing on desks and running around in American Studies. I remember Mr. Bernard freezing Maddie's computer when he saw that we were playing Webkinz instead of working on the yearbook. I remember the many class group chats in which we all vowed not to hand in an assignment and say we thought it was due another day, which, believe it or not, worked more often than our teachers realized. Memories like that are what make us special. Our personalities, while they may not be conventional at all, are what make us memorable. They're why we're able to persevere as a class during these challenging times, and they will be what make us successful in whatever we pursue. Class of 2020, your passion and your attitudes are what define you, and I hope that you never change them because it'd be a tremendous loss to this world. In conclusion, I'd like to thank Dr. O'Reilly, Ms. Lawson, faculty members and staff, members of the Board of Education, and every parent and guardian here. Your dedication to the class of 2020 is why we're able to stand here today. And finally, a thank you to the class of 2020. You truly have made these past 4 years some of the most amusing and definitely unforgettable. The best is yet to come for all of us, although I know that I've certainly gotten a glimpse of that throughout these last 4 years with you all. Thank you. I now ask Ms. Katherine Lawson, principal of Portland High School, to the podium to present the class of 2020 for graduation. Thank you.
Thank you, Autumn. I commend the class of 2020. You have truly persevered as thinkers, learners, creators, and problem solvers. Most importantly, you have demonstrated a unity beyond your years. One of the greatest privileges of my job is conferring the class for graduation, and it is truly my pleasure to do so. Therefore, as a result of your hard work, it is my honor to say, Dr. O'Reilly, Chairwoman Peters, and members of the Board of Education, I attest that we have reviewed the transcripts and academic program of the seniors before you this evening. They have met all the requirements for graduation from Portland High School. And I am very proud to present them to you at this time for the awarding of their diplomas. I will now invite Dr. Philip O'Reilly to the podium to announce the graduates.
Grant Edward Collins. Congratulations.
Nathan Edward Lavoy.
Congratulations, Nathan.
Madeline Alice Brunk.
Congratulations.
Autumn Maisie Tewksbury.
Congratulations, Autumn.
Olivia Runty.
Congratulations, Olivia.
Caden Richard Charpentier. Avery Elizabeth Coe.
Congratulations, Avery.
Megan Tracy Doyle.
Congratulations, Megan.
Julia Mayoko Fitzsimons.
Congratulations.
Morgan Ireland Lasky.
Congratulations, Morgan.
Hannah Jill Prince.
Congratulations, Thank Hannah. You.
Kelly May Tellerico. Abigail Marjorie Backus. Christopher David Bell. Lauren Chenier.
Congratulations, Lauren.
Mary Kate Laura Clark.
Mary Kate, congratulations.
Thomas Henry Currier.
Congratulations.
Nicholas R. Chapiga.
Congratulations, Nicholas.
Dylan Emmanuel Dowd.
Congratulations, Dylan.
Joanna Dapkus.
Congratulations, Governor.
Denasia Davis. Congratulations. Nicholas Matthew Dawson.
Congratulations, sir.
Adrian De Leon Reyes.
Congratulations. Right to the stairs, Adrian. Good luck.
Harrison Ned Dean.
Congratulations.
Gianni Di Gennaro.
Gianni, congratulations.
Michael Sebastian DeMauro. Stephanie Marie DeMauro.
Congratulations.
Brian Robert Dennis.
Congratulations, Brian. Good luck.
Joshua Andrew Doring.
Congratulations.
Olivia Rose Doring. Catherine Margaret Donahue. Timothy John Donahue, Jr.
Timmy, congratulations. No, you can't.
Andrew Paul Dumay.
Congratulations.
Indamari Ellison.
Congratulations, Indo.
Rachel Mariah Fasciani.
Congratulations, Rachel.
Janelle Kathleen Field.
Janelle, congratulations.
Caitlin Lorraine Philback.
Congratulations, Caitlin.
Carter Thomas Gange.
Congratulations, you've done that.
Clara Janet Gilmet.
Congratulations, Clara.
Thank you.
I miss your music.
Victoria Lynn Haglund.
Congratulations.
Athena Marie Harmon. Janaea Harmon.
Congratulations.
Carly Hasselman.
Congratulations.
Joshua Hurley.
Congratulations, John.
Neera Kadrick.
Congratulations.
Isaac Kendicki.
Isaac, congratulations.
Thomas Patrick Kevany.
Congratulations, Tommy.
Kian N. Keach.
Congratulations, Kian.
Benjamin Kelly. Congratulations. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Megan Hannah Castraba. Congratulations, Megan. Michael Edward Krasnewski. Great. Congratulations. Jordan LaBella. Congratulations, Jordan. Kyle James LaPila. Congratulations, Kyle. Faith Ann Lee. Congratulations, Faith. Stephen Lee. Congratulations. Adriana Colleen Lovett. Congratulations. Hunter Winston Lyman. Congratulations. Anna Laura Maslick. Congratulations. Jake Daniel Maza. Congratulations, Jake. Adam Matthew Meckensturm. Appreciate all your help.
Well, thank you.
Christopher James Maluzzo. Congratulations. Lauren Mertel. Shannon Nicole Murphy. Congratulations. David Prozelski. Congratulations. No. Adam David Rosignol. Congratulations. Amber Elizabeth Ryan. Congratulations, Amber. Brooke Nicole Ryan. Congratulations. Kelly Ann Schneider. Congratulations. Jaden Alexander Shopes. Congratulations. Olivia Courtney Smith. Khadijah Stanford. Congratulations. Michael Sterren. Congratulations. Rachel Ann Staub. Down here. Amanda Szabo. Congratulations. Victoria Tirado. Victoria, congratulations. Mackenzie Toomey. Congratulations, Matt. Andrew Joseph Vernali. Congratulations, Andrew. Chloe Everin Wade Freilich. Congratulations, Chloe. Michael Walker. Congratulations, Michael. Ethan Wallengren. Congratulations.
Congrats on retirement, by the way.
Thank you. Jack Wright. Now you gotta shave because you're enlisting. Emerson Elizabeth Wido. Congratulations. And with the setting sun, no less. Graduates, if you are comfortable to do so now, I ask that you step outside of your cars and remain standing next to your car, leaving appropriate distance between you and your neighbors, of course. I respectfully request that others remain in their car. And please don't wander from your car. Portland community and beyond. This is a unique and exceptional class of students. Young men and young women who have proven themselves throughout most extraordinary times. Their collective resilience and perseverance will serve them well as they venture out into many enterprises that await them outside this lovely town of Portland, Connecticut. As we all wish them well tonight and send them on their way, I am reminded about what I have said repeatedly to so many classes of students throughout my career as an educator. Perhaps some of you have heard me before. Follow your passion and your persistence. Follow your passion and your persistence in your efforts always and in all ways. I believe that if passion and persistence are your guidepost, happiness will be your companion. As I bring this ceremony to a close this evening, and I near the end of my tenure as superintendent of schools, it is quite clear to me that I am one of those lucky people on earth who has followed his passion in life. That passion has materialized in ways that I never dreamed possible when I was you in 1977. Graduates, I wish that all of you will encounter both the good fortune and awakening experiences that I have had for teaching children, leading schools, and leading a school district have brought me great happiness. And yes, being in Portland has been that thrilling capstone project that I desired when I came here in 2014. Class of 2020, I congratulate you and hope and pray that each of you will experience the thrill in the journey that following that passion will bring. Thank you, Portland, and may God bless these 2020 graduates. Ladies and gentlemen of Portland and beyond, this unique and exceptional Portland High School class of 2020. Thank you all for coming, and have a lovely summer.
It's us.